Now guys, if you've been considering an EV or a plug-in hybrid, you've probably come across a thing called brake regen or regenerative braking. Even this car has it as well. But EVs and plug-in hybrids do it a little bit differently. So, in this video, I'm going to explain exactly how it works and keep things as simple as possible. And in the next few minutes, you'll know exactly how it works. Brake regeneration is a term used to convert kinetic energy, your wheels and the car moving, to electricity to increase your range in your car. Compared with a normal car, when you push the brake pedal, it moves hydraulic fluid to help apply the brakes, which of course slows you down. The discs and pads press together, which causes heat, and most importantly, friction. First things first, as there are various plug-in hybrid and EV manufacturers out there, here's how to adjust it in your car. If you have a Mercedes, it'll be the paddles behind the steering wheel. If it's a BMW showcased in this video, or even a Volkswagen, sometimes it can be found in your car or vehicle settings on your center screen. Or in some scenarios, especially some of the newer cars, it can be found on the end of the gear stick or drive selector. And you'll be looking for the D mode for normal and B mode. B mode will increase the brake regen. And finally, if you own a Tesla, have a look on the big screen in the middle, funnily enough the only one in the car, and in one of the modes you can select either low or standard. If you have a different car, just contact your car manufacturer and they can let you know how to do it. And now a very brief summary of how it works with some examples on the road. Now, modern cars are very, very clever. They have a thing called brake recuperation or brake regeneration, depending on the term, and they do some extra clever things behind the scenes. Now, even my own daily car, I have a Mercedes-Benz A180 Premium. That's just a petrol engine, but it's also a mild hybrid. And the mild hybrid technology also does have some of this brake recuperation as well. Although it's not as advanced as this car, this car's got some very clever tech in it, which I'll show you in a second. So, what happens? Well, you have your electric motor for a start. So, for example, just cruising down this road at the moment, if I go to accelerate, you'll notice here the power will go up and you accelerate. But if I need to brake, it puts some of that power back into the battery. Without going into too technical kind of details on it, it basically uses that electric motor to reverse the polarity and put some of that power back in. Now, it's technically impossible to regain all the power back in, otherwise, well, whoever can invent that, you will have solved the internal combustion issue and everyone could just be running on free electricity. But sadly, it doesn't quite work like that. It only recaptures a small amount of it, but it is enough and it helps just increase the range of EVs and plug-in hybrids. Now, on some manufacturers, you can adjust the brake recuperation, and when you adjust it, this is kind of determining what happens when you take your foot off of the brake or the accelerator pedal. So if I take my foot off the accelerator pedal here, we're just going to coast like this, because this car has an adaptive mode. Now, here is a good example. Basically, as I'm driving along on a national speed limit of the road, this is 60, as I approach this car in front, if I take my foot off the accelerator pedal, you'll notice it will straight away go to adaptive and it will start to brake, and now I've already matched their speed. So I was doing like 55, 56 kind of miles an hour, maybe just a little bit more. Because the people in front weren't, it's kind of slowed me down to match their speed automatically. Pretty cool, right? And it did brake recuperation to do that. So watch me back off again. Let me just slow up a bit. We'll show the example again. Then we'll go to accelerate again, catch them up. And I'm going to take my foot off the accelerator pedal around about here. So notice the car slowing me down. I'm not literally touching the pedals at all, and it slows you down to match their speed. Pretty cool. Now, you might not like that. This is why you can change some of the settings. So, for example, if you had this on high, so I put this on high recovery in D, when you're driving along like this now, and you take your foot off the accelerator pedal, oh, it brakes quite a lot. There we go. Look how much I'm slowing down. I'm not touching the pedals. They literally almost come to a stop. How crazy is that? So this is where you can do like one pedal driving. Let me change this to another one and do moderate. So this is going to be less braking now. So back up to speed again. Foot off the accelerator pedal. I'm still feeling that braking. I'm going down like a couple of miles an hour every second, but not as much. Same thing again, let's go to low now in this particular car, get back up to speed again, foot off the accelerator pedal, and now I'm barely slowing down at all. So it's almost like putting your car in neutral is what this feels like. You're just kind of coasting along the road. Some cars you can turn the brake recuperation off completely and then you just kind of coast. That is literally like putting a car in neutral. But this is what you can do. You can adjust and choose your preferred mode based on your preferences. Most cars, when you brake anyway, it's going to still brake recuperate because it'll always do that first and then the pads and discs touch afterwards, usually when you come to a complete stop or in an emergency stop. This is purely just describing what it feels like when you take your foot off of the accelerator pedal and as the car slows down. So here, not much slowing down, but if you put it in high and then take your foot off the accelerator pedal, it'll slow down a lot like this. So basically means you could drive the car using one pedal if you're very, very clever, and that's also where the term one pedal driving comes from. Of course, guys, if you have any questions about brake recuperation or brake regeneration, let me know in the comment section down below and I'll do my best to answer. So guys, there we go. That is brake recuperation in modern cars. Now, if you guys have any questions, let me know in the comments section down below. Remember, brake recuperation is as easy as it gets. It's very similar to braking systems in traditional cars with braking discs and pads and that sort of thing. But it's just got a few extra tweaks where it kind of puts a bit more power back into the battery. Right, well, it started raining, so perfect place to end the video. But guys, thank you so much for watching. Hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you all very soon.